Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 26 Beta 3. iOS 26 Beta 3 is available to developers, and iOS 26 Public Beta 1 should be available usually within about a week or so. Normally, the public beta is released a week after Beta 3 when they do a Beta 3 re-release, and then a public beta after that. So that's typically what they do every year, so we can expect the similar sort of release schedule. Now, this came in at a fairly large 11.7 gigabytes for some reason on the iPhone 16 Pro Max, and I've seen this vary depending on devices people are using, whether that's the iPhone 16 Pro Max, an iPhone 11, iPhone 15 Pro Max, or others. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 26 Beta 3, tvOS and HomePodOS 26 Beta 3, visionOS 26 Beta 3, watchOS 26 Beta 3, and also macOS 26 Beta 3, but there is a bug where the overall silicon versions are not showing up. If you have an Intel Mac, though, it seems to be showing properly. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 23A5287G, and this particular build does have some changes and feature updates in it, and the first thing is, though, there is no modem update. Coming from Beta 2 to Beta 3, they didn't add an additional modem update, so no change there. Now, in addition to this, we do have some new features or changes. The first thing has to do with wallpaper. If we go into our wallpaper, and if we scroll down in wallpaper, you'll see we have some new options for iOS. So we have four different options now. So if we go into our iOS wallpaper, you can see as we swipe between styles, we have sky, we have halo, we have dusk, and if we go back there, you'll see we also have shadow. So if you want to set those, we can. And then of course we could maybe change the font, go back into it, and adjust it, and it sort of goes behind like you would expect. So it's sort of a nice little wallpaper there, and they've continued to add some. I would love to see them bring back maybe some of the older ones as well. Now the next thing they've changed has to do with the way Liquid Glass works. Here I have Beta 2 on the left, on the right I have Beta 3, and you can see the way it looks. In the Control Center, it's mostly the same. They're very similar. However, in certain apps, it's not the same. So if we go into maybe this one here with music, you'll see that it looks a little different at the bottom. And then as we scroll up, of course, we have similar glassy effects, but that gives you an idea of what it looks like. So there is a slight change there, along with a change in podcasts as well. So if we go in, it looks mostly the same, but a little bit less translucent there. But as we scroll down, you can see the effect is a little bit different. So it is easier to read, but some people just aren't happy that they've changed it. But there are changes like this throughout to give it better contrast and make it a little bit easier to read this time around. Also, they've added some of these changes to things such as maps. So if we go into Apple Maps, so with directions in maps, you'll see the overall bar here at the top giving us our directions is a little bit more translucent, and also they've moved the line to the bottom instead of at the top there on Beta 2. So slight changes, and you'll find this throughout. Also, another change I noticed is if we go ahead and take a screenshot, it no longer goes right into the menu where you have the options to edit. So on Beta 2, if I go ahead and take a screenshot here, you'll see that it goes right into the same sort of edit dialogue where we no longer have to do that. So now we could save to photos or we could delete it. Now it just goes right into the bottom here like it used to, and you can swipe it off the display. I think that's much more convenient than it was going into the edit options every single time. Also, there's a couple features worth mentioning that are in iOS 26 that I didn't mention in previous videos. If we go into News, for example, maybe we're in a recipe here under News Plus, scroll down, and under the ingredients, you can now add all the ingredients to a grocery list in Reminders, making it much easier to remember what you needed. The other thing that's new has to do with maps. If we go into Maps, Maps will now allow you to search with natural language, such as coffee with good Wi-Fi. It will find good Wi-Fi with top-rated coffee shops. So this is a nice little update here. Also in this update are quite a few bug fixes. In fact, it feels incredibly smooth just opening things such as the camera, going into music. It's much less choppy than it was before, but it's not perfect. There's still issues throughout. For example, if we go into volume here, we can bring in volume, and sometimes Liquid Glass will just appear, other times it won't. It seems like it's a little bit delayed. The overall experience, though, seems to be a lot better in that I've been using it for the past hour or two, maybe, and it seems like it's a better experience so far. It should be by Beta 3, but again, it's hard to tell after using it for just an hour or so. So we'll talk more about this in the weekend follow-up video to see what it's like to use for everyone. Now, as far as the release notes, if we go ahead and take a look at the public-facing release notes, there's quite a few in here. And if we go to things such as new features, we can see that recovery assistant I talked about with beta 2, but quite a few fixed issues. For example, some iPhone 15 and 16 models might show a low battery symbol and be unable to start up after updating. Lots of things have been updated in this version. Some of these are old, some of these are new, but of course there's going to be bugs as this is a beta. So if you are having bugs, be sure to check this out here. Look through all of the notes. As you can see, there's hundreds of them with many different fixes, probably 50 to 100 fixes in this update, and there's still some known issues. So new things for Metal, resolved issues here for Metal, if you're developing apps, and lots of other issues as well. So be sure to look through this, and if you are having an issue, be sure to report it in the Feedback app. So go into Feedback, report it there, and then sometimes Apple will reach back out asking for more feedback about something. So if you're wondering if you should install iOS 26 Beta 3, if you're on Beta 1 or Beta 2, absolutely, try it out, provide feedback, and see what it's like. However, if you're not on this version, maybe you're on iOS 18.6 betas or 18.5, I probably would not install this at this point. I would hold off, wait for the public beta, as we're only probably about a week or so away at this point. And as far as when to expect that, if we take a look at the calendar, based on what we've seen before, like I mentioned, maybe early next week we'll have an iOS 26 beta 3.5 or 3.3 re-release or something along those lines. Then usually after that we'll have public beta 1. Then we'll have public beta 1, then public beta 2 will come out after iOS 26 beta 4. That's typically what they do, but we'll probably be a couple weeks off until beta 4, maybe around July 21st. Of course, this week we could also see iOS 18.6 beta 3. However, we don't know the exact dates of that. It could also be next Monday as well. They haven't given any specifics about that just yet. We still haven't seen an iOS 18.5.1 either to fix issues that many people are having. So hopefully we see something soon, but at this point it looks like they're focused on iOS 18.6. As far as overall performance, well, performance, like I mentioned, seems to be pretty good. I'm sure it's still processing in the background, as it seems to be decent. ProMotion is kind of what you would expect. It seems like it's ramping up and down and smooth, but again, much less choppy than what we had with Beta 2. I had lots of bugs, restarts, and things with Beta 2, so hopefully Beta 3 is much better. As far as the overall heat, it definitely is still getting a little bit warm. I can feel it on the back here. It's processing something in the background, which is pretty typical after you've installed a major update. So I would hold off on that if you're concerned again with that. And when it comes to battery, again, this will take some time to test, but it's been pretty horrible for me on this beta or beta 2. Hopefully beta 3 improves. If we take a look at battery health, I'm at 99% with 255 cycles. It dropped right when it hit 250 cycles. That's what I'm seeing for a lot of people. As far as overall usage, well, it's getting me usually a couple hours. So 3 hours and 43 minutes of screen active time yesterday with 14 hours and 56 minutes of screen idle time. And I used 91% or so of the battery and charged it a few times. I've found that I've had to charge it a couple times throughout the day with this beta. So hopefully, again, it improves with beta 3. But we'll only know that after testing for a few days. So be sure to check back for the weekend follow-up. As far as overall storage, well, let's go ahead and take a look. We'll go to General, iPhone Storage, give it a moment to load here. Now with Beta 2 on the left, Beta 3 on the right, we'll scroll down to the bottom, and you can see Beta 3 is taking up less storage space, even on the 16 Pro Max, compared with the 15 Pro Max on the left. So 6.16 gigabytes for Apple Intelligence, 13.72 gigabytes for iOS. So a little bit smaller there, maybe they're refining more things, so 19.88 gigabytes compared to 21.21 gigabytes. When it comes to overall benchmarks, it was pretty decent considering it's still processing in the background with 3,407 for single core, 8,140 for multi-core. Compared to what we did before with Beta 2, sometimes I would have terrible results. This is actually a little bit better and closer to the margin of error that we would expect, around 8,500 for multi-core and 3,500 for single core. So overall, pretty decent in general. So that's everything with iOS 26 Beta 3. As I find more features and changes, of course, I'll keep you updated. And of course, let you know in the weekend follow-up video. Let me know if you found anything else, though, in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.